This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes the flexible budget and how a flexible budget differs from a master budget, how a flexible budget is used in the process of evaluating how a company is doing. So the first bullet point here is actual sales do typically differ from budgeted sales. So the master budget, which we talk about in a separate video, the master budget uses actual sales. It's created before anything actually happens for that period. It's created in advance. So our master budget might show that we expect to sell, let's say, 200,000 units, and it will then show what we think our costs will be, along with our revenues. It'll show what we think our costs will be for producing and selling 200,000 units. Well, the flexible budget would look at this after the fact. The flexible budget would take the actual sales, and from the actual sales, so after the fact, look at actual sales, and we would take the actual sales times the budgeted cost per unit, and that would be our flexible budget. So the flexible budget is based on actual sales and budgeted costs per unit. The master budget is based on budgeted sales and budgeted costs per unit. The last bullet point here, the costs in the flexible budget then are compared to actual costs to evaluate how the company is doing, to evaluate how the company is performing. Here's an example of a flexible budget. And the first thing I want to point out is that it is based on actual unit sales. So this is actual information, not budgeted information, but after the fact. Let's assume that we produced and sold 210,000 units for the period. And we take that actual sales information and production information and multiply it by the budgeted, or often called standard, cost per unit. So we take the budgeted or standard cost per unit and we multiply that by the actual number of units produced and sold. And that is what gets us the flexible budget amount. And here you see it for, as an example, you'll see it for direct materials and direct labor and variable overhead. This is the production area of our company. And we just simply take the standard cost per unit times the actual number of units produced. And that gives us our flexible budget. And you'll see that here with these three items and with the total. As I mentioned in the previous slide, the master budget assumed that we were going to produce and sell 200,000 units. So again, that's before the fact, and actual sales are always going to be, almost always going to be different than budgeted sales. So that's what we had for budgeted sales. It turns out that our actual sales and production was higher. And it wouldn't be fair to evaluate our production personnel on this on 200,000 units in terms of the budget if we actually produced and sold 210,000 units. So we're going to modify the budget so that it reflects what we expected to see in production costs with actual production.